Here at UVM, we have this concept of hunch and crunch. We have scientists with ideas about the ways that the world might work, and we have incredibly powerful computers now that help us answer some of those questions.
So my area of study is human brains, brain structure, brain function. One example of a study that we're actively involved in is the ABCD study, so adolescent brain cognitive development. So this is a landmark NIH study, one of the biggest projects they've ever funded. Typical studies have 25 participants in them. We have 12,000. The brain imaging data alone is about 20 terabytes of data per participant.
I'm a computational social scientist. We have lots of great instruments to reflect how well the economy is performing, but we don't have things like that to describe how people are feeling. The hedonometer is a project that we've been working on for about 15 years now. It takes a random 10% of all of the messages posted to Twitter. So we have several machines that are taking all of this data that's streaming in, the fire hose of tweets, and then we create instruments that allow the public to interact with that data in a way that preserves the privacy of the individuals who are contributing to it and allows scientists to answer questions about what's going on in the world.
If you want to characterize, let's say as an example, adolescent development, you can't really do that with 20 participants and claim to be able to say anything that's representative of the nation as a whole. The turning point right now is that there's this huge push towards very, very large data sets, which means the complexity and just the sheer size of the data has multiplied. So to be able to perform these analyses, historically this would have taken thousands of days on a regular computer. We can now do these analyses in an afternoon, thanks to the AMD donation.
The AMD HPC donation was $500,000 in cloud compute credits and $500,000 computer cluster here at UVM. Expert skiers who are looking to go really fast take Black Diamond trails, and the AMD cluster got the name Black Diamond because it's the fastest machine we have. Parsing all the data that we get from Twitter used to take us over 24 hours, and now we're able to do it in less than 3 using the new cluster.
So essentially what we've done is we've created a new scientific culture in which my students assume that these computing resources have always existed. And this is ideal because it means they can devote all their energies, not to the infrastructure to make this happen, but to actually the scientific questions that are driving their passions.